Hello and welcome! My name is Adaria Volkova and this channel helps you utilize Grafana to its full potential. This video is an overview of the HTTP API Grafana Data Source, a plugin that simplifies working with Grafana's backend. I will also share a quick step-by-step tutorial to give you a better idea of how to work with this data source. Are you ready? Let's go! You most likely already know that Grafana UI interacts with the Grafana backend by using HTTP API. What you might have yet to discover is that all these HTTP API endpoints are public, meaning they are open to the end users. On this documentation page, you can find all available HTTP API endpoints. Using those, you can access existing annotations, dashboards, user information, etc. Though Grafana HTTP APIs are open to end users, there are more user-friendly approaches to work with Grafana's backend. For instance, if I open my Grafana, here in the drop-down of all available visualizations, I have the Annotation List panel. If I select it, the data source area disappears. This is because the Annotation List panel is coupled with my local Grafana instance. For the annotation list panel, in addition to all usual things, my local Grafana also serves as a data source, and these annotations are coming from the local Grafana configuration storage. Another example is the dashboard list. Again, there is no data source, and those are the names taken from the local Grafana instances. Panels like the annotation list and dashboard list fall into a particular category of panels – widgets. Let's go back to my schema. The widgets fits here between Grafana UI and the HTTP APIs. I display them as a tightly coupled panel and data source. Two main characteristics of widgets are: they have a particular purpose with limited customization. They always connect to the local Grafana instance. And now, here is where the HTTP API data source fits in. The HTTP API data source dramatically expands the functionality of the existing widgets. With it, many limits bite the dust. Off the bat, the configuration and application data can be displayed using any visualization panel. And you determine which Grafana instance the data source should work with, local or remote. This also means you can connect to as many remote Grafana instances as needed. In the local mode, the data source uses the same user privileges as were assigned to the user during the login process. Let me open my Grafana and go to the connections. It is a new menu name, before it was called Data Sources. I already have the HTTP API installed. Click this area. Here I have a local request mode. Here is what I see if I click remote. It requires a URL and a service account. And now let me demonstrate the HTTP API data source in action. I'm going to create a dashboard with two visualizations. One is the time series showing the device's temperature. In this other video on my channel, I explained how to build it in a great detail. These vertical lines are alerts. Grafana adds them when the temperature exceeds this specified threshold. On the bottom, I have the star of today's demo, the alert history. It displays all alerts in a table view with the time when the alert was generated, the name of the device that generated the alert, the name of the metrics, and the value with a color-coded background. For the medium urgency, I have yellow. For the high urgency, the background is red. As an eye-candy bonus, on the left, I have the variable panel. I can move it to the right or anywhere on the dashboard, but I like it here on the left. In this variable panel, I can specify which device to display or if I want to see all devices simultaneously. To create an alert history like that, I add a new visualization, and in the edit mode, I select table as my visualization, but it could be any other panel from the list. Data source, Grafana API. Next, request dropdown. Those are all available types of requests for this data source. But again, Grafana provides many more API endpoints and we can add any of them in the future following the community requests. I select annotations. Type alerts. Annotation here has a different meaning than in the dropdown. Here it is a short for native annotations. Records that have been entered manually. Alerts are the records added by the Grafana Alert Manager. Dashboard All, which instructs the data source to disregard the dashboard ID when selecting from the annotation table. Time range selected. It means to use the time range specified for the whole dashboard over here. For this demo, I use all previous statuses and new statuses, but filters are here if needed. I will get back to the text pattern in a moment. The max limit is the number of alert records to fetch and add alert fields I set to disabled. Now let's take a look at the label column. This name indicates which devices have triggered the alert. To retrieve this vital piece of data, I use transformations. Go to the Transformations tab. I like the makeover this tab went over in one of the latest Grafana releases. Instead of simple listing with a word description, now you have a self-explanatory images. Bravo to whoever came up with this. Do you also find it helpful? Leave a comment. I would love to hear your opinion. I select Extract Fields Transformation. The source is column I want to apply my conversion towards. I select Labels. Keep the format as auto. Here you go. With that, I get three extra columns in my data frame, including the device name. Next, I want to parse the values column. For that, I add one more transformation. Add another transformation button, exact fields, specify value, format auto. Three more columns appear, A, B, and C. Remember that color-coded column with temperature? It is stored in this column B, however, in text format. I add another transformation, convert field type, and select B as a number. There are no visible changes yet, but you will see in a moment why I need this data type conversion. If I look at all retrieved columns, there might be too many. I add another transformation, organize fields. Here I can hide all unnecessary columns. Here you go, the view is coming along. I can instruct Grafana to use aliases instead of column names. I want the name to start with the capital N, alert name renamed to alert, and B into value. The next step is to set up the color-coded background for one column, value. I do it with the override property. Add field override, I want to apply it to the column with the name value. Then add override property button, thresholds, add threshold. Another add override property, cell options, cell type, colored background. Here you go, the color will reflect the data range the value falls into. If I return to my transformations and turn off the convert field type, the background doesn't work as I need. The B column, which has the value alias, must have a number type for the threshold to work correctly. My dashboard looks like this so far. When I select another device, the time series reacts accordingly. However, the alert history does not. To make the alert log follow the selected dashboard variable, I use the text pattern. Specify name equal to a dashboard variable metric. This variable is the query type, which retrieves data from my PostgreSQL with the query to select all device names from the metrics table. With that, I can alternate between device 1 and device 2. The panel reacts by showing the appropriate records only. However, when I select all devices, the dashboard variable is assigned an array, device 1 and device 2. With that, my text pattern does not work and the panel doesn't display anything. Grafana has plenty of built-in string parsing functions. You can find all of them on the variable syntax page. I'm going to use the regex. I specify the semicolon and the word regex. With that, Grafana transforms my array into one string written as a regular expression, device 1, pipe symbol, device 2. With that, my panel displays all devices when all devices are selected in the variable panel. To sum up my demo, using HTTP API Grafana data source, I get access to Grafana configuration and application data following a couple of easy steps. The HTTP API data source is a game changer when working with the Grafana APIs. Let me know what you think about this plugin. Check out our blog page to find the latest release notes. We ensure to provide a picture for every new feature, so it takes seconds to learn what's new. That is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.